C'est quoi le mot pétrin, pétricide, pépi, pépui, pépop?
C'est bien.
Par exemple, did you see improvements in your vocabulary slash speaking?
Bon matin, tout le monde!
Moi j'avais un cours ce matin, Léa vient juste de finir son vidéo d'un lookbook et je pense qu'aujourd'hui, puisqu'il fait beau, on va faire une petite dernière tournée de vélo de la saison peut-être.
Et on va parler seulement en français!
Peut-être tout noir aujourd'hui.
Pour un rappel, je vous présente mon fit.
Ok! Aujourd'hui, je vais porter un peu de maquillage parce que normalement, je suis très paresseuse et je porte rien. C'est porte-maquillage? Oh, c'est beaucoup ça. Ok, après mes sourcils.
Oh shit, Ilya.
Quoi?
Apparently, Angelica's going to IKEA right now.
Oh, vraiment?
Yeah, do you want to go? If you don't mind coming to pick us up, that would be awesome.
Okay, I'm on my way.
Super.
Angelica, can you teach us Russian?
Sure.
La svidania. On va prendre une petite pause de français. On va aller au IKEA avec la belle-mère de Andrew. Parce qu'on a besoin de préparer un peu pour la transformation de l'appartement. C'est bon ça ou non?
C'est tellement bon, c'est le pancake et j'ai ajouté le walnuts et le pétri de citron. C'est quoi le mot? Pétrin, pétricide, pépi, pépui. Oui, j'ai lu les commentaires ce matin, quelqu'un m'a dit le mot pour si papine.
He literally can be on his front paws and lift his back.
So cute.
Là, j'ai vraiment l'air d'un ours.
Je vais faire une lumière pour le plafond avec papier. On va utiliser ça.
Crème glacée végétalienne.
Vraiment, c'est vegan?
Oui, des hot dogs vegan
aussi.
C'est
beau!
La lumière est tellement belle. Ok, ça c'est le crème glacée framboise. Pour toi. Ok, et maintenant le hot dog veggie.
Il y a des oignons aussi.
Ouais.
Oh yeah, that IKEA drip though. Wow, oui, wow, $30. Qu'est-ce que t'as fait aujourd'hui?
Pourquoi tu pousses pas bien là?
C'est comme à la dentiste.
Oh Foxy.
Oh mon Dieu.
Oui,
je suis d'accord avec Kimia. Ça dépend sur l'espèce des animaux. Comme par exemple, au Canada, il y a le phoque et ils sont pas un animal en danger. Donc, c'est pas illégal de chasser le phoque. C'est vraiment pas égal pour les animaux.
Le
pâte celui-ci, c'est vraiment la meilleure pâte que j'ai jamais mangée.
Mais non, t'exagères.
Oui, non.
Impossible.
Non, c'est impossible. Tellement vrai.
Écrivez dans les commentaires votre forme de pâte préférée.
Je veux savoir c'est quoi tu manges maintenant.
Non, on devrait demander aux gens genre de mettre des recettes dans la description. Puis nous, on peut essayer de faire leurs recettes.
Ouh, en vidéo, fais les recettes de mes suivres,
de mes abonnés, de mes
abonners.
Abonners.
Bon matin.
tu cesses de me raconter n'importe quoi.
Très bien. Par exemple, vous pouvez dire à quelqu'un, on a envie d'aller au cinéma aujourd'hui.
Ok, mes amis, j'ai reçu plein de questions sur Lingoda, donc I'm gonna do a mini Q&A in English to be super clear because I get these questions all the time in my French videos. If you don't know what Lingoda is, basically an online language learning school, and they teach French, Spanish, English, business English, and German. Once in a blue moon, they do a really cool sprint program. So what I did was the super sprint, and that's 30 classes per month for 3 months. I did this from July to September. You get 100% cash back. If that's too intense for you, there's also the regular sprint, which is 15 classes a month. And if you successfully complete it, you get 50% of your cash back. One of you guys asked, hi Lee, I want to sign up for the sprint, but Lingoda put me on some kind of wait list. What is that? Because the classes are actually with real teachers, I mean, it's 24/7 all around the world and it's international, it's open to everybody, but they do have limited spots. So if you don't sign up in time, there is a wait list. And the most common question that you guys are asking is, when is the next sprint? When is the next sprint? How do I join? I want to join the next sprint. Ladies and gentlemen, the next sprint will be starting January 15th. Perfect for everyone who wants to do a new language as their New Year's resolution. But you do have to sign up before December 28th. I would sign up even earlier if you can, since the spots are limited. Why did you want to learn French? French is a second language of Canada, so I actually started learning it in school because I didn't have a choice. But when I visited my family in France, I just like fell in love with Paris. I spent some time in Nice as well. I also want to be able to speak to my cousins because they're half French, half Chinese, and their Chinese is not looking so hot right now, so I'm probably going to be speaking French to them in the future. Did you see improvements in your vocabulary slash speaking? Is it efficient? Yes, I actually did. So I did all of like the mandatory French in end of elementary school and into high school, but those were always like grammar sheets, and you're in a class full of people who are speaking English, don't really want to speak French. So none of us could really actually converse in French. And it's only through like immersion trips that I was actually able to learn, but those are really expensive. I feel like they're not really accessible to everyone as Lingoda is. Prior to the class, I wasn't really speaking much French. Even when I did my internship last summer in Montreal, I was just so shy that I didn't really speak. I barely spoke French to Andrew. Like, it was only when I started doing Lingoda and I got in the habit of like speaking a bit every single day that I became more confident. So now I can like do these vlogs in all French. That being said, I did have a basic understanding of like the grammar and vocabulary, etc. But the sprint definitely helped me improve my vocabulary and just improve like the recall time, because you can learn grammar and all these things, but if your mind isn't going fast enough because you're not practicing, then you might as well not be able to speak the language, you know? Okay, a really good question is, would it be better to do Lingoda uni or like do in-person classes after COVID is done? Someone asked, is it hard doing these classes online? Just because I know right now a lot of people are doing online classes and it's really tough. But, fun fact, I actually tried to take German in university and I literally dropped out my second class because it was so boring. Oh my god. One, because there's like a class of 20 people and you're like waiting for every person to answer like what they did on the weekend, or like for every person to repeat a certain word. Like, it just gets so slow and boring. I just like start mentally clocking out. Ow. Whereas the Lingoda classes online are usually like 3-4 people in your class. I've also stumbled into a class where I was the only person, which I was really nervous at first, but it ended up being amazing because it was like I paid for a private class, but I didn't actually. Some people ask if it's hard, does it take a lot of time, is there a lot of homework, can you do it while you're also a full-time student? I was taking it pretty leisurely. I wasn't doing any of the homework because none of that is mandatory. Like, you can do it, but you don't have to. So I wasn't, because I'm just trying to chill but practice speaking. Like, sometimes I feel like when I do something too intensely, then I don't want to do it anymore. So I feel like doing 1 hour class, even if it's every day, is super nice and gives you some type of like routine within quarantine. Is it more speaking or writing based? So you can actually choose your courses. I mean, they have like units and lessons in order, but you can actually jump around to whichever you prefer and like change
levels if you find the one you're in is not suitable for you. They have different types of classes, ones that are speaking-based, writing-based, reading-based, and skills-based. But going back to the thing, it's like, is it manageable to do as a full-time student? Think about like how many hours you spend on social media a day, like how many hours you spend on Instagram or on YouTube. If you spend more than 1 hour, maybe you spend two, like then I think, yeah, you got an hour time a day to do French class. If you want to engage more in the material outside of class time and study, you can totally do that, but it's not mandatory, which is what I like because I feel like it doesn't put pressure on me. Yes, I successfully completed the sprint. I just read over all the rules, like you don't book two classes in one day. Don't like cancel your class after you book it. It was pretty straightforward. I mean, if you do one of these things, you can keep doing your sprint. You'll just be disqualified from like the 100% or 50% cashback component. But even speaking to people who did get disqualified from it because they like forgot to go to a class or something, like they said the price is still really worth it, which I agree because I've taken other French classes and they're like even university classes, it's way more expensive than Lingoda. But if you want to save a bit more money, I do have a discount code that you can use to get 10 euros off of your deposit if you choose to do the sprint. Yeah, I hope that answers some of your questions. If you have any more, you can just leave them down below. And let's continue with the vlog.
J'allais juste me faire un café, puis celui-ci, ça goûte le cream soda et les fruits tropicaux, apparemment.
Tu n'as jamais pas le pantalon, hein?
Arrête, je m'attendais pas à me faire
mais
filmer.
Mais c'est vraiment mignon, les pantoufles.
Honnêtement, je les adore. Puis avant, je me disais que les pantoufles, ça sert à rien. C'est pas vrai. Ça, c'est comme une petite maison pour mes pieds.
Oh. Aujourd'hui, on va faire les petites rénovations.
Mmh. On va prendre les étagères, on va les mettre sur le mur.
Mmh. Installer la lampe.
La lampe, oui. Je veux pas que ça nécessairement soit collé au mur.
Parce qu'après, j'ajoute la lampe.
Ah oui,
là.
C'est vrai. Oui, oui.
Ça, c'est pas trop nécessaire.
Ouais, c'est vrai.
On y va.
Bon. Look at me.
Hey.
Je vais acheter ça pour ma mère.
Moi j'aime ça le plus. C'est tellement beau. Peut-être ici. Que je perds là. Oh, c'est
bien. Regarde, c'est ici le mur, le trou pour le mur.
Nouvelle lampe, comme un hôtel. Ouais, on peut faire le dentiste. Regarde le vibe.
Quand je demande à mes amies québécoises pour des séries en français, ils me recommandaient Occupation double. C'est un télé-réalité. Sujet de la mort, hoeing. C'est très québécois et très stupide. J'ai hâte de l'écouter ce soir.
C'est plus trashy, non?
Ouais, c'est vraiment trashy.
On entend souvent dire que l'important c'est la beauté intérieure. Eh bien, c'est ce soir que nous allons tester cette théorie.
Wow, c'est tellement dramatique.
On a tout un bon feeling, on peut voir de quoi il a l'air, donc...
Ah, donc les filles choisissent les hommes. Le broiness de Amérique du Nord, mais en français.
Ouais, c'est ça, c'est la culture québécoise.
Damn.
Les demoiselles.
Aucun candidat d'occupation.